What's up YouTube, The Kid's Good here, and you're watching the first video in a series called Reviews for Improvement. And as always, if you like this video, be sure to smash that like button. We're gonna try to go for 50 likes on this video. Reviews for Improvement is a series where I go back and review gameplay footage to see where I got outplayed. Because in my opinion, that's the best way to improve at Fortnite. You know, you can think about how you died after the match, but if you actually don't go back and review your gameplay or footage, you're not going to learn what you really did wrong and what you can improve on so that you can change that for the next fight. So my plan is that once a week, I'm going to go back through my footage and pull about 5 clips and review how I died, how I got outplayed, and what I can do differently so that it doesn't happen again. So I figured, why not just make a YouTube series, because I'm sure a lot of you are going through the same things. So if you feel like you can improve by watching these videos, be sure to hit that subscribe button because I'll be posting one of these videos once a week. So jumping right into it, in this clip right here, I actually landed at the gas station right outside of retail. I like to do that because it allows for me to get a decent amount of loot, and then I can rotate relatively quickly into retail to clean up and get the rest of the kills. So as I go ahead and push up here, I hear that the guy that I was going up to kill has already been killed by somebody else, and I don't necessarily want to run on the roof and expose that I'm here so that I might catch him off guard. But he goes onto the roof, and then I end up being able to kill him, and then the guy who was trying to shoot him comes up, but he doesn't know that I'm here just yet. So I still want to stay silent because I want to get a couple of shots in before he knows I'm there. After I get a couple of shots in, I want to go straight for trying to build over him. The issue is that he beats me and I'm out of materials, and this is where I make a mistake because I go to just shoot straight out the side to turn on him and try to build back over him. But when I get to the top, I realize that I've ran out of materials, putting me in a pretty bad position for him to come right over the top and finish me. That's why it's so important to monitor your materials at all times, because had I known the amount of materials I had, I wouldn't have gone about that fight just like that. So in this next clip, I start getting shot from behind. So I instantly spin around and build. My biggest issue is that I'm overusing materials at this point. But I do have the advantage because I have a hunting rifle and he's only shot at me with an AR. So I kind of want to keep my distance and try to pick away at him before I start ramp rushing him. But if you notice, one of the things I don't do is I don't build very high and ramp rush straight for him, because he is pretty aggro and I don't want him to shoot me down and me to take fall damage. Now where it starts to go a little downhill is that he starts throwing these stink bombs, which causes me to have to reposition out of the smoke. And now he has the natural high ground. So there again, I'm still gonna try to shoot him and try to pick away at his health just before I ramp rush him. However, I do manage to hit him for about 80. I should have used this time to turtle up and get my shields up, because I'm down to about 50 health now, so he probably has an advantage. However, I choose to just ramp rush straight for him even though he still has the high ground, which is my biggest mistake. Now at this point I have a couple of options, and I choose to take the worst option possible. What I should have done was taken the lower ground and tried to reset the fight by shooting it down, because it would have forced him to come back down to my level so that we could reset. In this clip right here, it's a classic rookie move of not using height to your advantage. So I heard some shots, I climb up over this, I see this guy, I come over the top to finish the fight. And I want to obviously shoot down the trap and then get his loot. Now, as I'm looting him, I hear somebody sniping at me, but even more close, I hear somebody building very close. So as I turn around to build back to where I came from and get into a fight with this guy, I completely choke. I have the advantage of height. I could have easily built over him or at least protected myself. Ultimately, giving up height advantage lost me the fight. Now in this clip right here, I actually heard these people fighting as the circle was closing, so I decided to approach and bring him down with the overly broken explosives right now. This guy here was just an innocent bystander. The guy I really wanted to kill was up here. So naturally, after I shoot him down, I want to try to take the high ground and finish the fight, although he starts throwing the stickies at me, not allowing for me to get as high as I'd like, and then he uses that time to take the height advantage. Now I could have played this a couple of ways. I could have stayed under and shot him down, but I decided to go up and build because I think I can outbuild him. And honestly, he was a much better builder than I anticipated. So I quickly make a move to try to regain the height from this guy, but he's a much faster builder. And where I made the mistake is once he blocked me off, I should have turned around and went about it a different way, but I chose to shoot him down, causing him to come down on top of me. Now, I couldn't have known before getting into that fight that he was a better builder than me, but once you start getting outbuilt like that, it's time to rethink your strategy. So I've got to give it up to this guy. He starts shooting at me from behind, causing me to turn around, and I kind of have to take a defensive stance on this when I clearly only have 50 health, but I do know that there's a crate behind me that I eventually need to get to try to see if there's meds. What this guy does that so well is that he suppresses me down and continues to move forward to head towards the natural high ground. Now, for some reason, I got the minis out of the crate, but I didn't use them. I pick up the RPG, and I just kind of try to go for the lucky shot. What I should have done was use the minis and or went straight for the natural high ground, because I still have the high ground at this point, so I have the better shot at trying to get up there. Now, by him spamming me like this, not only is it stopping me from being able to ramp up, but it's also stopping me from being able to use my minis. So now that he has the high ground, I decided to go ahead and pop my last mini, and instead of moving out or trying to get into a different position, I stay right where I am, allowing for him to shoot right on top of me and being able to take me out. I hope you guys really enjoyed the video, because I had a lot of fun making them, and I'm going to continue to make these videos once a week. So if you got something from this video and you want to try to get better with your improvement and your gameplay with Fortnite, be sure to hit the subscribe button, turn the notifications on, and I hope to see you guys.